Hi Virgo, welcome to your High Priestess reading. Everything for 2020. Everything you need to know about this reading is in the description box below, as well as the recommend a reader shout out, which goes to the Jezebel Way Tarot. Love and support to her. Check her out and show her some love and support. This is intended to be a romantic love reading, but certainly not limited to that. And it may resonate in other areas of your life. Also, this could be yours or your person's moon rising or Venus. My voice has been weird this past week. So I got my lozenges and my water at the ready. So just FYI. All right, for Virgo. What is going on with your intuition? What's going on with your intuition? About your relationship, about your stuff, about your life. Virgo, intuition, Five of Wands, oops, Temperance, that could be Sagittarius, Five of Pentacles, we got two fives, Magician, Gemini, Virgo, or Aries, Six of Swords, Page of Cups, the Star, this could be Aquarius, that's an eight, right? Three of Cups. All right. Three, five, and okay. So we got two fives. So what are we dealing with here? If we got two fives, what are you not talking about? Or not? I'm getting some water because my throat's, I can feel it. Why is this crooked? I don't understand why. Okay, so we've got not a standoff, but there's definitely been a line drawn in the sand here. And this is, can you see that? Yeah, okay, all right. Nope, not backing down. Well, Six of Cups reversed. So somebody can't let go of something here. Somebody being petty or childish. What's this Five of Pentacles about? This Five of Pentacles. Are you waiting for someone to do what needs to be done? Or, I mean, to grow up or to meet you halfway on something? That could be Virgo. That's Hermit. What's this Magician about? Knight of Cups. So Six of Swords. So Six of Swords. Eight of Wands. So this Page of Cups. Okay. What's this Star card about? Do you think this is temporary separation? It's not. What's this Star card about? This is you moving on from somebody. Ten of Pentacles. What's this Three of Cups? This is you, Four of Pentacles. All right. This is you needing to be around, people that love you, care about you, and can uplift you. And it's a time for you to have levity and joy and get back to being social and with those that maybe you have taken a break from to deal with this person who, spoiler alert, if it's not a person, it's a just romantic situations for you in general. But in the romantic area of your life, this is somebody who's not going to meet you halfway. This is somebody who is not rising to the challenge. There might be there's something that they're keeping from you. It could just be that they're, that they have this just chronic issue with being petty and childish, but this is something that a lot of their energy goes to managing. This could be a very selfish person that you kind of, it could be that you keep ending up with the same type of person that is just selfish and self-absorbed and really focused on themselves. This is somebody that is wanting to cut ties with this situation and move on. So you're going to need your tribe or your person. And the thing is that you know this. I think you were hoping for something different. But intuitively, this is you. Intuitively, you know that there's not much more you can do to make this situation work. I think you and your person are in separation, and you were hoping that this was just temporary, that they would think about things. They would be feeling this disconnect, think about things, and want to come back in with an offer to maybe make things up or to make things right. But I think intuitively you know that it's gone as far as it can go, that you can't do any more to make this work, that this person has got to meet you halfway, and they're not interested in that. They're actually actively trying to get over this. And there goes my voice. I'm getting some water. All right, get my little cough drop here. Okay. This is, I think you're needing to accept, and I'm preaching to the choir here. The Virgos that I'm reading for know this, that this is, that right now what you need to do is, oh, you can't see that, can you? This is you needing to let this ending stand. This is not somebody that is going to, and I'm sure there's frustration about this, but this is, you're having this, it could be that this is realizing that it was always kind of up to you, that it was never really worth it to your person, and that you did a lot of the work, and that you chronically choose people that are selfish or that aren't going to give you what you need. But for this person in particular, it's kind of taken a lot out of you. It's good that you're in separation. You've got better coming. You need to be in separation from this. And intuitively, you know that. That this is a time for you to pull back, to regroup. That this is, it's simply time to shift your focus from that person to restoring yourself and your stability and your groundedness. No more energy and effort towards this person. No, it's for Virgo. Ten of Swords. There's that ending. This, it might be in, you might be in separation right now, but you need, this needs to be a permanent ending for you. No more energy on your part towards this. They're already pursuing something or someone else. They've already got designs and plans on something or someone else. Maybe it's looking for their next victim. Maybe it's their next project. Maybe it's the next relationship. Not impugning their character per se, but their focus is not on reconciliation with you. And neither should yours be with them. What else for? Here we go. Okay. Six of Wands. Good. Good, good, good for that Six of Wands. Six of Cups. All right. So, again, with the being around people that can resource and help you through this, or just be a source of comfort and joy and laughter, people that are on the same page, perhaps this is you giving your all to a relationship that did not work out and did not deserve your effort. And intuitively, you know that. It's just hard to accept the ending and that this person can just so callously, literally ride off into the sunset with somebody else. But this is about being with your tribe and finding people of like mind. Perhaps this is dating, but this is considering it a victory that this didn't work out, so that you don't have to expend any more energy to a situation that just, to a person or whatever, it just wasn't working. You're not on the same page. Not on the same page. And you need to stand your ground. This is you coming full circle and realizing, no. I got a ping earlier that there might be bat going, well, I don't know what to do. I'm sorry. I don't know. No. This is a grand exit. They don't get to come back after that. You've been there before with them doing this. This needs to stand. This is you being like, I'm free. I'm liberated. Being happier for this ending and knowing that it's right. Knowing that it's ran its course and knowing that you get to now get back and return to your stability, because this is a pattern with this person and you can't fix or manage this. It's not, no, enough. So this is, and as far as your involvement, your capacity, consider that this might be either out of loyalty for longevity, like you came up with this person, you know this person. This could have been a long-standing relationship. You knew from this person from once when. There's been a lot of back and forth here. You're kind of fed up and you're done, honestly. And you're, yeah. For the Virgos I'm reading for, this says everything right here. This position, this yay, that yeah, you're done. Consider it the liberation that it is. There's going to be some disconnect and feelings of sadness and whatnot, but this, you were going to be here again with this person and you know it. And it's time to return back to your stability and your happiness with your tribe. That's for Virgo. That's for Virgo. King of Swords. That could be Gemini. They're also, aside from the fact that this might have been somebody that you came up with or that you've been dealing with for quite some time, and there's longevity or loyalty at play, this could also be that this has to be deal with some issues from, you know, just some things that need to be revisited. Like, why do I have this assumption about people, or why do I think I deserve that, or what's going on? Like, I didn't even realize this was riding shotgun in the background, you know, sort of informing my choices, if you will. So what's this Six of Cups about for Virgo? It's this Six of Cups, because this is a happy exit, so it's okay. That's why. Two of Cups. This could be you overstayed, or you gave it your all, because that's what you do when you're in a relationship. This could be a long-standing relationship. This could be the naive, right? Not saying that it is, but really hoping against hope that this would work out, that this person would come around. But no, this person doesn't deserve your effort or your faith. Worst case scenario, they're very childish and manipulative and selfish. Best case scenario, they just don't want what you want and you're free to find somebody else that does. But this could be that you need to check your notions about what it means to be in connection or partnership with someone. I don't think so. I think that you, this could be you examining this. This could be you going online to meet somebody. But I feel like this is you kind of wanting to keep things light and be with friends and family and loved ones that can recharge you and restore while you think about this, while you get some perspective on this. And you look at what partnership and love and soulmate connection, if you subscribe to that term, means for you. That you examine long-held beliefs about unified love, about falling in love, about being a couple. Because you've got the time to think about it now. Your effort for that situation is done. Spoiler alert, they very well, for this grand exit that they made, they could be coming back to say, I don't know what to do without you, or I just, no, don't even answer that. That you don't get to fix that part for them anymore. You've given enough of your effort. This needs to be about you now. About things being stable and grounded and resourcing you and restoring you. And you get time to think about this while you are with your tribe. This is a year of things being light and you taking a break from intense dating or intense connection. While you process this ending and you kind of take a look at what you want in partnership and in love. Because this one is certainly food for thought. I mean, gave you enough information. But this is about you putting this into perspective very quickly, might I add. Very soon, if you haven't already. and kind of coasting the rest of the year. You might date, but it's not going to be intense partnership, exclusive connection, because that's what you're going to be taking a look at. This is you coasting. We got Temperance and we got the Star card. Definitely you taking a time out from this, having come full circle through this, just being like, no, no. And if you're waiting for reconciliation or reconnection with this person, that is short-lived. You're not going to be thinking that way very long. You're going to go very quickly from holding vigil for that to becoming like frustrated and being like, you know what? No, I don't, something's going to come to light. You're going to find something out very quickly, like within the next month, to where it's going to go from this Five of Pentacles to this Ten of Swords energy, to where you're just kind of like feeling this disconnect and kind of it could go either way, to being like, oh no, a definitive ending. Like, no, what's done is done, no more. And you feel better off without that situation or without being involved in that, because it was kind of taking its toll. You're due for a much needed rest, much needed time to just have things be light and fun and date if you want to, or go do this if you want to, or go travel there if you want, whatever. But it gets to be to where nothing is taxing and asking of you like this relationship was. Like where you had to be kind of the bigger person all the time, you know? That was fun. Yay. Yay. Blessings. Because, let's be honest, you're due. This is enough. Enough of you having to be the bigger person and the responsible one to somebody who just didn't really care either way. And then we'll have the audacity to show up back in May-ish. I don't know what to do. Well, you did then, so figure it out. Because I'm done fixing everybody else but myself. Done focusing on everybody else but myself. Thank you. All right. And my lozenge wrappers. Okay, hold on. I like this. I like this because this is you getting your good this year. As you move throughout the year, this is going to release its hold on you very soon. And this is you being open to this and things going your way, because you accept the ending and you give yourself that time to heal. And you just, instead of being frustrated with someone asking for time apart, you're like, oh, that's a blessing in disguise. I will take it, because I'm having a lot of fun now. I'm doing a lot of things. I've reconnected with my friends and family, and just everything's working. Everything's in sync for you. I like it. Now for Virgo. Okay, Temperance reversed. There's Temperance here. This could be Sagittarius. And this, okay, 2, 4. Nine of Pentacles. Okay. Temperance reverse. That could be Sagittarius. Things out of balance, overtaxing. This could be somebody who's very, again, with that very childish, selfish, self-focused behavior. Someone that this could be dealing with imbalance in mental health issues, you know, a lot of imbalance, or the relationship, everything fell on you. This could be someone that wasn't very balanced and acted in a very irrational way, had excessive irrational demands on those around them, took its toll, and you're like, I'm out. I'm only concerned with taking care of myself and my own now. This is bringing your self-esteem and your self-worth back into alignment, perspective, seeing it for what it is, and leaving this situation behind and progressing on your own, which is preferred, because this is about you restoring and refilling yourself and taking care of yours and your own only. No more with this imbalanced situation and unreasonable demands on you. Okay. All right, Virgo. Let the blessings begin. Yay. If you're kind of feeling stuck here, you won't for long. Something's going to happen to where you're like, are you serious? Really? And it's going to flip things. Right now, you might be waiting. You won't be for long. This is that hump you got to get over, because intuitively, you know, this is for the best. It's just, it's hard right now, but it won't be for long. Okay. All right, Virgo, I hope this was helpful. I hope to see you in the next reading. Love and support to you this year, 2020, the year of hindsight. Okay, you take care.